Welcome to Planet Perryn. Planet Perryn is where the campaign is going to take place.
It sure looks like it, yeah.
It's a world much like Earth. Albeit probably larger. You'll find out. What you're seeing right now, this is kind of the nearby environs, okay? But closer to home, which is this map, this is the area that most of you are familiar with. For as long as your peoples can remember, including the elves and the dwarves, although it's said that there was a time that they did not exist, there is the race of Agars. And the race of Agars are the dominant race on this planet, as far as you know. And it is something that you, as different peoples, and as a people as a whole, have to deal with. It is a fact of life. Agars are anywhere from 7 to 8 feet tall. They are humanoid. They are covered in a thin layer of hair, or fur, one might say. They do have canine teeth. They are meat eaters. They're omnivores, but their preference is meat. They're carnivores by nature. They ride horses, Clydesdales, because of their size. All of the... you're pretty sure that all of the things that they have, Clydesdales and wagons and foodstuffs and gold and silver and even weapons finally made, and especially food, is provided by you, the intelligent. We'll just say the decent peoples. Okay? They eat you guys. To them, you are cattle.
And those of you players that had missed out on this session, or for just new viewers who are watching, at this point in this adventure, the party has actually been captured by a small band of Agar. These Agar were traveling through the region as a solitary group, which is very rare for the Agar. So that was strange in and of itself. However, upon the Agar's arrival to where the party was at, which I will get to in a moment, they immediately took them captive. Now, prior to the party getting to this location, they had heard rumors from all the way back as far as Rome that some strange occurrences had happened down past the village of Vingra. And they decided, they're curious to get the best of them, they decided to investigate that. As they got to the village of Vingra, the small locality was in quite a stir. They were quite excited. They had met with what were called visitors. And these visitors had a small camp, again, kind of southwest of Vingra. They had been there for a couple of days and had been trying to communicate back and forth, trading simple things such as food and tools. And they were definitely a strange folk, not dressed or used to the customs that are local. So it was quite an excitement, quite a discovery. These new people who had arrived out of nowhere, it seemed. And the villagers were trying to communicate, make friends. Well, as the party arrives at Vingra and go out to meet these newcomers themselves, along with a few villagers in tow, is when they find the group of Agar. The Agar have slain 5 of the male members of these visitors and captured a female, one of the visitors. These all seem humanoid, either human or elf, possibly. And they have them, as well as some of the local villagers and maybe some yet to be identified people, in these cage wagons the Agars are hauling with them. The Agar group consists of about 7 Agars, 3 team drivers, one driving each wagon. A couple of guard Aegar. These guard Aegar seem to be in attendance of a minor noble Aegar, a young noble from his banner bearer, and the penance, the human flesh penance flying from said banner. This is a young Aegar noble. Again, strange for this group of Aegar to be out on their own. But it is unfortunate for the party that they're at the wrong time at the wrong place. So we will proceed from there. It is at this point that the party has been put into the wagons.
Both my guys.
Any dissenters?
That's why I had to roll two characters up. Pulled on account one.
Can't test to see what happens.
Then I'll move this along. Your gear, your weapons and gear, are put in a third wagon. You, all of you together, are put into the first wagon. And the other humans are, they're hurt. This female appears to be unconscious. You can see that she's breathing. Those others in the silver, tight-fitting clothing are dead. This may, for some of you, this may be the first time that you actually are actually now elbow to elbow. Okay. The Aegar that locks you up gets back on his Clydesdale. The banner bearer says, no, don't. And to make that point, he shoves his spear into the one human. She's an older lady, didn't look like she was going to make it anyway, and runs her through the ribs. No, and so, with everybody now captive, the one Aegar with a very long spear rides right next to the wagon, and the procession moves off in a west-northwest route. And they're heading towards the hills.
The girl?
Yes.
He didn't say anything about moving. Tegun's going to move over to her, see if she has any wounds. See if she's dead, check her.
She is just barely unconscious. But closer inspection too. I'm going to get you a picture. That's what she
is. That's your cleric.
No.
That's your cleric.
She's an elf.
Okay.
That's her tight fitting clothing. She does have a collar type necklace. Strange looking, but it fits firmly about the neck, and it has what appears to be a large blue gem right here. Like I said, she's just barely unconscious, probably about a negative one hit point. There's rocks sometimes, and there's unevenness, and there's that little river and such. And it's near sundown when one of the wheels on your wagon goes out. And there's a bunch of commotion, a lot of Aegar cursing. There's not much to do. You start to realize what they're doing. They go to wagon number two, and out of it they pull the wheel. Okay. A bunch of cursing. They order you out of the wagon. Okay. Then they begin to order you the best way they can to get lift the wagon up so that they can get, you know, and then have one of you put the wheel on. Well, this isn't going too well. All right, and number one, this wagon is way too fucking heavy. So, you can tell it's kind of confusing because you don't really understand what they're saying. And Zeebo's not, like, running around translating. But you see one of them take a huge axe out of wagon number two and head off towards some trees. And they're going to, basically, they're going to get some wood. You can tell by the way they're pantomiming to each other that they're going to prop this damn thing up so they can get a wheel on it. Right. Anyway, a couple of the others start a big fire. They take all the horses off the wagons and bring them over to a little area where they can graze. And I'll show you this map. Excuse me. All right. And it is as, I'll get my mouse. Where's my mouse?
Can't
hate it. Okay. So as the Agar noble, and who's standing about right in this area with one of his guards, you have a guard right here watching you guys, and a guard out here, and the one's already brought back half a tree to cut up a couple of big old blocks so they can get the wagon up on it. Any remaining ones are down here by the horses. Okay. These are all the draft horses. Got about, I had about four to each wagon. And if not, I misplaced them. They're underneath the tree. These are the ones that that they ride. I missed one or two. And so it's now dark. And that is, you guys, you don't have chains on. And you realize these guys can run as fast as you, not faster. So, you know, it's kind of up to you if you guys want to make a bolt for it. But Zeebo, walking around with one crowbar, because he was, you know, they got some tools out for you guys to work on this now. He's meandering a little bit. And he goes back to those two barbarians. He says, I'm getting out of here. Because I've been hearing them talk. They're going to eat tonight. And he'll walk off, he'll come over, you know, and he'll walk by the elf and the half elf. Get out of here. Sucking me out of here. You're not supposed to. Don't. And in his little ministrations, he says, you guys can join me.
Where are the rest of them?
Most of them are down by the horses. Right hand corner of the screen, sort
of. Yeah. Most of them are right in here. You got one probably about 30 feet from you.
And we're in that first wagon here.
And you've got one.
We're near the wagon.
He's now underneath this tree.
Right. So we're near that top wagon, correct? And all our shit's in the very bottom one. Fuck. How many other people are with us?
I don't know about you guys, but barbarians can run for days.
They put that one in the trees to sleep.
I wish I'd run the fucking business.
Is the girl conscious yet?
Oh, she's fixing it.
Now, let's see here. Uh,
So we're in the wagon or out of the wagon?
You're out of the wagon.
We're out of the wagon. Is the one that broke his heart or something?
You're all right there in front of the top wagon. Right there by those wheels.
And then all their random junk is in that middle one? And our weapon equipment and stuff is in that third one?
It's in number three. Yeah.
Alright. Besides the horses, are there any other wildlife?
Just birds and trees. And it is dark.
Right.
Oh goodness, I'm in hell.
Another note that you would know. As far as you know, they are not seeing the dark.
Okay.
By the way, I made that map. Thanks, Paul. I made all the maps.
Well, I mean, I know. I'm just like, I didn't have that much. I kind of went to a lot of trouble picking the crap out. Okay, if we can take out that
guy here's next to it. So this is going to take a little bit of time. So we're going to have to be sitting here gabbing real quick. He didn't say not talking today. Whispering and shit. So, and I want all this, got everybody up, kind of facing different directions and shit, but kind of in the general 10-foot area. Around.
By the way, does anybody speak halfway?
We never got to languages.
Okay. Well, I thought maybe it's inherent.
Yeah,
probably. Okay. Because I guarantee you, a couple times Zeebo would have said it halfway.
I wonder what you guys think and look around and see if somebody would have understood what he was saying. We were pulled away and ready to go. We didn't want to take him on. Now we have shit.
No,
you guys
no,
are unarmed.
Well, no. Well, I mean, it's dark, and
oh yeah,
they're gonna eat.
As far as we know, they can't see.
They're gonna eat. Okay, so this.
They're gonna eat one of us. There's only.
We are gonna have nothing.
Hey, Randy.
Yeah.
Do they eat the dead people? Can they eat the dead people?
They would.
I mean, because
they would want fresh meat.
Well,
so
then
could,
why are they keeping the dead ones?
My cleric.
I mean, they could just throw.
I don't care about who's on.
You know what? We're gonna roll. I'm gonna roll some
percentile. Let's see here. 70% chance.
I get a horse, but
70%
of that animal friendship.
If you can name a horse, they don't know.
Right, they're pretty far over there.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna drop that idea. The birds aren't gonna fucking help me.
They could.
I can only tame one at a time.
Yeah, but if you tame the bird, then the bird distracts.
While this is going on, he kind of nonchalantly kneels down next to our silver clad young lady. Imitate the pose he had in the wagon. You know, so cross legged, kind of going like this, back and forth. But he's going to put a hand on her arm. Okay. In between him and the guard.
Sure.
So he don't see. He's going to do the imitation. He's going to cure my wounds on it.
Okay.
All right.
Roll it.
Something Zeebo would have related to. Zeebo keeps walking around that crowbar like he's pointing at the wheel and thinking of ways to fix things. Says that in common, but sometimes he whispers. So he thinks they're keeping us strangers
alive, or not alive, but he's keeping them. You're not supposed to eat them. Karkorth might want to know about them. They're different.
We could use point at him and say,
seven. Two things happen. The desired effect of healing her. Okay. She starts to stir. At the same time, that necklace of hers, or whatever it is, that band around her neck with the big blue gem looking thing, glows super bright.
Oh shit.
I mean, not. But just.
Well, I'm gonna kind of. Well, I'm sitting next to her. I'll try to block that light, but, you know, I'm still imitating what I was doing in the wagon, so it doesn't look like it's out of the norm for me. You understand? That's why I would do it.
She, because you're right there next to her, she looks at you. You can tell she's terrified, right? And as her eyes dart real quick, she says, and here's a strange thing. Her lips don't match the sound.
Got it.
But what you hear is, what's happened? That didn't match her lips, though.
Okay.
Quiet.
It's like watching one of those
12.
Yeah.
Okay.
Quiet.
We're figuring out how to get out of here. And it may happen real fast, so be prepared to run.
And she goes, okay. Except it, her lips don't say that.
Just don't move, stay where you are.
But she's got steely nerve now. Not Steely Dan, steely nerve.
She's got as much help as me too, bro.
She's got what?
And she has more.
She has more?
She has more, yeah.
Well, I meant from the healing.
Yeah,
she's got more than we do. From the healing.
Jesus. Everyone and everything have more hit points than you.
Except for the old lady.
I was thinking that spider.
No lady's only got a couple more hit points than you.
And that's because a cockroach keeps stepping on. He's got more hit points than you.
Must be nice. Average human has one or two.
Alright. Are you good?
What did you say she had? Before you started making fun of Brandon? Steely what?
Nerve.
I mean, from the paper, it's pretty obvious. Okay.
So.
We're still figuring out.
Zeebo and his out loud talkings and then coming over. Says maybe you could help unlock the wagon. You guys can see in the dark.
I don't think I can unlock this guy's wagon.
It's like I got shit in there. I want to get out.
I'm gonna whisper back to
some of this. This will help a little bit. Those tools.
Zemo's got that crowbar. Zemo can get in. It's not gonna be quiet, but he can get in.
Maybe if you had bird with the strength of your arm.
It could do that.
Have it fly.
What kind of birds are we talking about?
It doesn't matter as long as it pisses them off enough that they.
Well, there's how many's out there? Seven altogether, one size to us.
You just need to get one distracted. It can affect normal fires. It can make their fire get huge or really small.
Well, if you make it huge, they'll see us running that way. If you make it small, they'll just walk towards it to relight it, and they're still coming closer to us.
Well, no, we're up in the top.
Yeah, but they're going to come this way to get the fire. We need to make that way.
Well, but if the fire goes out, lights dim. Do these monkey men, werewolves, have good eyes?
He said, as far as we know, they can't see in the dark before. So if you put their fire out, we have a better chance of getting over there.
I'm going to have to read this spell to see if it's right up on it. It's business.
small
bag. Pretty sure I had to be like right up on the bird.
Wagon.
Chance of me getting close to it or something.
20 feet.
Per chance, you free your guide.
These are 10.
Okay.
We'll call them 10.
Sure.
So you've got no one. Let's say you're about here.
These are the points.
No.
You don't have more
alone? No, I have to be right on this. Half a foot of level.
If we're going to do this, we better figure out how the hell we're going to do this.
So everything we're doing on that way here, I guess. That almost works.
Okay. Over there by your foot. Gotcha, fire. If we're gonna die, might as well get it on the map.
Yeah.
Okay. Alright, we got the woods over here.
Is that the woods or is that just a big tree?
It's the woods.
That's woods.
That's a like big tree.
That one, that's what
a
I'm
huge,
about
huge
that's
oak. Okay, so that's a tree.
So that forest, we're going to way over there. Okay. How many? Is there a tree close to us? Can you pull that up, like, up a little?
Horses, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
So yeah! Yeah.
That's it. Birds.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Okay, horses. And we got fire. Then we got guard number one, right about here.
What's that thing up there?
Guard number two. Out by another tree, approximately. Yeah.
He's by that tree? He's not by out?
He's out by that tree or under that tree, I think is what he said. Okay. Right there. Now, and then you got the other horsies.
I'd have to pray to make the land right fucking next to me.
Over here. Horsies. Then the other bad guys.
You're fine.
And then we got woodline and shit over here.
I don't know how this works.
Are you marking? Where you're good enough.
And we're approximately here, right?
He has to deem that my player's good enough. I'm not in your city or something.
Okay. Oh, no. You don't. It's just how you do it.
Now, there we get the map.
Okay,
this is something like that. Us, wagon, bad guy guard, big tree. Draft horsies, big ass tree, other bad guys, riding horses, other wagon with equipment, their wagon with equipment, and then over here we got woodline ish here.
Okay.
Okay.
So we need that last
one. And then whatever this bit thing is here.
It's probably just another type of
rock or tree. I don't know why there's rock or tree or some shit. That's true, too. Okay. That's a different kind of tree.
It's a little like oak or ash tree or something.
Yeah. Name. What do you suggest?
Straight.
Make a diversion on the fire. Make it go bigger so they're all in there. Two people sneaking out here.
You have to be like on the fire. You have
to be half a foot away from that fire.
Yeah,
I just went, what are you doing? I'm close to the fire. I'm just going to get
it. I'm cold.
It's July. You guys want to have to run away. If I walked over to that fire, you guys want to have to run away.
I'm going to go opposite direction. So make it brighter. We make it go out.
He still has to be.
He would still have to be practically at the fire pit.
How was that thing happening?
You feel a pinch. What's your guy's name?
Which one?
The cleric.
Suvius.
Pinch
her arm.
I stole one from
Destiny.
And she goes.
And Sarah.
It kind of unsnaps, right? It's a metal band, probably.
Well, it does.
It unclasps, right?
It's not ankle. It's
still kind of glowing.
Like,
first, she says.
Sarah is pretty much ankle.
Yeah.
Where it is.
I will probably need to use this. You won't understand me afterwards. She pulls it off. And she says, look, that date don't fly.
How sends a translator?
And she just kind of puts it down out of sight.
So the translator could do something else, but... translates and detects some magic. It doesn't say how close it is.
So, is the plan trying to make a distraction, get to the wagon, get some weapons?
That's
and
our plan,
running?
But to be able to teach an animal to do something, I need a week training.
Yeah, you're not going to teach any animals to do anything.
No, not like minutes. So,
minutes or a snack?
Yeah. I'm useless. So, wait, what happened to my horse? Or did I have a horse?
If you did, you don't.
I know, but did they kill it or did they just take it from their own?
It's probably sitting where we left.
Yeah.
It's probably someone else's, no?
Son of a bitch, she was a nice person.
It made a clean getaway.
Well,
it's safe.
Thank fucking God, because they weren't going to eat him. Thank God he got away.
Actually, one of the Jaeger would have scratched its nuzzle. Petted its jaw, slapped its butt, sent it on its way. Agar show more respect to horses than they do you.
They help a lot more. We're just they're useful.
Horses are their side bitches.
Side bitches.
Well, I can do something that freaks them out. We got to know what to do.
I don't have anything.
I don't mind.
I do. Okay, I mean, like, let's.
I don't
want to
freak them out. Who knows what the hell they're
getting. I can put a light spell right in the middle of that fire and make it rise right out of there and start running off towards the horses. I don't know if that'll affect them at all.
What are you gonna do?
It might scare the horses away.
It'll scare the horses and they'll
be cool.
Like,
but the problem is, Mr. Guard hopefully ain't looking at me when I'm fucking back.
What are we gonna do?
Okay, first of all, who's going to the wagon to get the weapons?
Probably Zemo, because he has the crowbar and somebody
else. He can't even carry a big ass spear.
I suggest one of the Bonarians.
I'll try to put him to sleep. The one that you're worried about.
Which one? The one that's right in front of us?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, we don't know if that other guy behind us is looking at him. Like, this direction just sees him, like, fall over. Because he's asleep, or...
But then that thing goes off and add more to it. Agar just died out of nowhere.
Okay, well, we do have to...
For those of you that can see, this one here tends to face this way, just in case something were to come out of the woods.
Okay, so... But if we did cause a distraction with that fire and run off towards the other horses, that guy way back there is going to be like, oh shit, maybe I should go help them. So, our window
of
opportunity...
This guy's not watching.
Well, he can try. He would hear the horses, though.
So... And I'm spitballing here, you guys have something crazy. We gotta have at least 2-3 people go that way and get weapons. And you gotta grab as much as fast as you can and run. Problem is, we're not gonna be able to find each other out here.
I have...
Especially with a bunch of other fucking bad guys running after us.
Right.
Second problem.
Fuck.
This guy, as soon as he hears something going on, he's gonna turn around and come right back.
Right, so our window of opportunity won't be just... He's knocked out, and then we run. He's knocked out.
Well, you put him to sleep. These guys aren't going to be paying attention. We can all maybe start meandering off, but
and
we're
then
not
you cast
getting
that spell
anything.
Once we get that way. That way he's going, and we can take
we
off.
Can put him to sleep, and then put him to sleep.
Maybe.
Yeah, maybe.
They're 3 hit die.
Yeah.
My thing was, if we're going to try this. All right, so.
Should we put all my characters in there?
This is Suvius Thane. He's your cleric. Alright. This is Tegan Sul. He's your barbarian. She's awake now. And I'll reach over and kind of tap your knee and let you know. Okay? Because you're a big barbarian. You might be able to carry her if you need.
So that's our bitch. And that's... Okay.
What I was planning on doing, we're talking... We gotta have a couple things happen here, and it's gotta happen fast. I mean, fast.
Right, okay. Maybe on the other side of that way, I'm sorry.
And anything you got to do, I mean, if you got a sleep spell, awesome. If you got.
Do you have a sleep spell?
Light spell?
Yeah. It's the fairy fire, so I can at least target one thing and light it up.
And make it hard, easy to hit if we need.
Or
so we kill one of these guys, they're killing 1,000 somewhere. What we gotta do is run.
Like, I don't know if this is gonna work. I meant like, so we work. Could find each other. We so, can like light up
my plan.
Zeebo, since he's the smallest point, and just follow him.
My plan is I can sit here and I can cast what's called a light spell in the middle of that fire.
Yeah. Right. What's it do?
It's a ball of light.
These guys are huge.
Okay, so
it's a really bright light.
That I can control.
That's what I thought it was.
And I can do it 120 yards away.
How far away are
they? Well, these are 10-foot squares.
So not 120.
And then make it rise out of there, swirl around, and go towards the horses and try to spook them to get these guys going, oh shit, what's going on? They know we're not supposed to know magic.
Yeah.
If that distracts them, you gotta put this dude to sleep.
I said we put him to sleep.
Or put that guy to sleep. Because if he turns around, it depends on how disciplined these guys are. Something starts happening over there, he may just sit there and watch us.
So like how they got this, we need to read.
If he does, you're going to put him to sleep. And if he don't, you got to put that dude to sleep.
Okay, I can put up the truck cast at 4.
Okay. You and the cleric, or in the little fella,
Zeebo,
are going to have to get down here and grab as much shit as you can get, because you can pick him up and run. I know you can, because I'm one of you. We're fast.
You're fast.
And we can run.
We can run for days.
Okay, well, the rest of us are kind of fucked. But.
Well, you know who dies first, right?
It's the big
motherfucker.
Not me.
The big slow target.
And I got nothing on
so,
if you got any kind of spell, you don't want to light up Zeebo because he's going to light up Dead Forest.
Well, I don't know how bright this light is.
Bright enough that it's...
Well, it's fairy fire, just like somebody that makes them easier hit. That's what you plus one to hit it for.
So it's not like the okay. We see it's pitch black out there.
Now... And you probably ought to go to the wagon with him. With Zeebo and whatever his name is.
Perryn. He's got two characters.
Okay.
So, my cavalier?
Your druid.
My druid.
Your cavalier is going to have to...
Get ready to have to kick some ass.
Yeah.
Just hurry back with your fucking weapons. Cause I can't.
I guess you all four can go down there. I mean, because somebody's got to grab the girl and take off. I don't know what she's going to do. So I'm going to have my barbarian, or my cleric, after he does his little light spell, because he's going to make a dance around and go that way. Barbarian's going to have to grab her and go. Cavalier's going to have to cover ass. Barbarian, halfling, and druid are going to have to get here, grab as much shit as they possibly fucking can, and go.
Okay, well,
magic user... What, like I said, if you don't turn around and start taking notice what's going on over here, he's going to have to watch. See, as this is going on, he's going to have to watch which one of these guys is going to be causing a threat. And that's where the Cavalier comes in, too. Because they start coming towards us.
We're kind of fucked. How far can you cast that sleep spell? Is there a range on it?
I'm pretty sure I can get close to it.
Because
there's a good range also.
Yeah.
I was going to say, if there's a good range on it, you might just be able to just save us the worry of having to
now here's
worry about one of them and just hit both. Just hit one.
This may not go to plan. And if it don't,
right.
The only
so
thing
like,
you do...
What's our first step? The light ball or the sleep spell?
Light.
The light?
Because we got to find out if he's going to turn around and bite on it or not, or if he's going to sit there and watch us. Because if he watches us, we can't do nothing. We got to get his distraction. He's watching that.
Right.
Now, if he hears enough noise, he may decide he wants to turn around. And in that case, he's going to see these folks running down over here. Now, if they both watch us, you're going to have to do your best.
It's only
pick one
it's only
and put them down.
Well, you're going to have to wait until they get pretty damn close.
And then a cavalier and a barbarian will have to tackle him or some shit.
Okay.
And so there's going to be damage taken.
Right. So it's going to be me and Perryn.
Kern's going to the wagon.
Current's going to
be my.
You're a barbarian?
Mm-hmm.
How do you remember you say it?
Tegun Sul.
Tegun is going to grab our damsel in distress.
Yeah, but he's going to make sure that he's between her and danger.
Right. I'm backing him up with what I named Jace.
Cavalier.
With my cavalier.
Yeah, because you got hit points with stand hit.
Yeah.
That's why. We both do.
So we don't take off until these threats are gone, right?
depending on how it works. Now, one basic rule in D&D, if you can't win, run.
Yeah.
I mean, you don't have to necessarily, because we got no weapons. The only thing we're going to have is try to pummel him, tackle him, or take him to the ground, cause, and he's 8 foot tall.
And he's 8 foot tall, and we got two of us.
And he's probably got a big-ass sword on him.
Yeah, probably.
Now, if this plan sounds crazy, tell me now.
I mean,
you guys are going to try this, right?
Or we can just sit there and wait for us to get
eaten. Hopefully they do get eaten.
How many dead people?
They capture us all, beat us up, and throw us back in the wagon.
That's
the worst thing that can happen, right? We could die, we could beat back up, throw back in the wagon, or we can get eaten.
Or
we can escape.
Or we can get away.
Okay. That's not the worst thing.
How many extra people were in the car? Cart, Randy? Live people.
Now three.
Extra.
Yeah. And
live people.
They're not fit for travel.
They're not fit for travel.
Don't waste it. You might need something else.
Run into a wolf. Make him your friend. You can't talk to him, but you can make him your friend.
A wolf? I mean, I can give it a shot, but I'd probably die.
Everybody clear on what we want to try to do here?
Yep.
Yeah.
Now, we got to be in agreement. Do we want to do it?
I don't know. My chick's going to get pretty pissed off if you just leave those guys there for them to get eaten and not us.
I don't know.
Ain't much we can do about it.
I know. Oh, they're all around the fire?
All around the minor noble Agar.
Is this the minor noble Agar?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And they're like,
whatever the fuck that is.
Maybe they're stocking frame right now.
One number, you guys.
Fuck. Yeah.
They're hungry.
So, here's the deal.
They're arguing about who gets to eat us first.
Can they sustain themselves on one of us? Or,
no.
Well, I meant, like, how far will one person go?
However far they want. You know that. You've heard of the moon feast too.
I was here too.
They don't have the setup here for the moon feast. Moon feast is really, that's always reserved for nobles, especially the Karkorth's table. From what you've heard, moon feast is where they bring in some cattle, some of the finest pieces, fresh and alive, and then they. You guys ever seen that thing on Faces of Death where they crack open the live monkeys?
Yeah.
Let's go.
Never seen it. Faces of Death.
Okay. Well, they do that with you guys at the moon feast. They saw off the top of your skull and eat your brain while you're alive. Well, that's the moon feast.
That fucking sucks. So they're going to be coming after us because we haven't bled out. Nobody's touched us. You're almost dead because they grabbed you too forcefully to put those handcuffs on.
Comes with a 20-point damage.
Ow! Okay, so.
It's funny. It's hilarious.
It is hilarious. Not for you, it's for us.
It's funny for
That's
me.
That's one
too.
Less person we have to feed if you die. We don't want you to die, though, yeah, because we'd be fucked without you.
Or I could go backwards. I could cause darkness over here and blind them in a 20-foot radius. Or do you want chasing a light bulb?
How did they start the fire? Like
probably flint and steel.
With flint and steel. And is that in that second cart, or did they carry it with them?
Yeah, one of them had a pouch.
In a pouch. Okay.
Darkness would give them less vision, but it gave you guys less vision too.
Not the people who have to cast the spells. Well, him.
We would see fine. Else.
I mean, or I don't better. Have to cast a spell right now.
Well, just to clarify, too, if you cast darkness, it would be down there.
It'd be in one spot.
And then I could move it. But I have to sit and concentrate on it, too. But once I stop concentrating, it'll stop moving and stay there, and I'm going. Because it lasts for a certain duration, I can control where it goes.
Okay.
That sounds better.
So we're causing darkness?
Yeah, because then if we do that, then you guys could, like,
well, but then
go grab the gear, come back up to where we are.
I understand, it's only 20-foot radius.
Right, so.
So, it's a big ball, 20-foot.
You hear the noble cry out, yell out, Fatamata! Fatamata! He turns and walks over there.
Let's go now.
Yeah, the time is nigh.
I look at her.
Okay.
And I point at the big barbarian,
the other, my other guy.
Got you. And I'll muddle my little prayer to Athena.
I'm going to sneak up on him to class C.
What?
I'm going to sneak up on this other guy to sleep.
How far away?
3 feet.
3 feet away from him?
Yeah,
how quiet are you?
I got dexterity of
17. 3 feet for sleep?
I think it's 30 feet.
There. That'd be 30.
It said 3.
Well, 30. That's
what
a, that that's a weird, means that's a weird thing.
The top, that's 30.
That was designed a long time.
We gotta let you guys know that.
Okay. Well, then I'm gonna cast sleep on him.
How far away is this tree?
It doesn't look like it's 30 away. Yards.
30 yards. So that's like 60 feet.
Yes.
So he's within your range. Okay.
Yeah, you can probably hit him from here. No.
Spell effects 2d4 hit die of monsters. Monsters with 4 plus 3 hit die. No more are unaffected. So it may work, it may not. We don't know. We'll see. Okay, so I'm going
to
cast.
No, I'm getting ready to cast.
My darkness or light, guys? Darkness?
What? That wasn't part of the pitch.
You're going to have to go kill him.
How am I supposed to kill him? I don't have any.
No, I think we decided on darkness.
Darkness. All right.
Before you do that, if this doesn't put him to sleep, you want his cavalier to go up on him and we cast him.
No, no.
See what he does. The thing is, oh shit, what's going on? You guys have to book to this motherfucker.
We can't see it.
And
it's
try to
dark.
Bust it. No. 20-foot radius over here.
Right, but how? Where are we going?
They're coming back.
This is normal night. No, we're
got the swords out.
We waited too long.
Come out. Yeah, I can't wait anymore.
Darkness up.
Okay,
you cast darkness.
We're at.
We're on top of him.
Okay.
So they can't see us.
We're running for the supply wagon.
Okay, so.
You guys roll initiative.
I don't know what you roll for initiative.
Can't
I don't
know.
Do I have to roll?
Just these two. I just want to see which one.
My cleric or my. Cleric.
One's cast.
Whichever
one's cast.
Caster.
Let me see your 10.
Alright.
Or you can easily.
Is this
or
less.
Or you can easily. You can easily tell me. Are you waiting on him to do that?
That one.
That's all I needed to know. All right.
Wait, what?
Okay. You cast
darkness.
Oh, right there.
All right. Ideas. So all of you immediately see this big black spot.
Running for the supply wagon.
Okay.
Really?
Shouts of alarm. Right? From the two in there, as well as the ones back there. This one stands up.
Right. Can I save on him? All what right. Do I roll for that?
You don't. You get to save with throw versus spell.
So where's your sleep spell?
Okay.
Save throw. None. Falls over.
No saving.
Actually, just slumps.
Slumps over. Okay, so druid sure. And.
Okay, so we got him.
Now you can all roll initiative.
Now we can
flee. Yeah.
This one's a 10?
He goes.
First of all, real quick, I'll try this style tonight. I'm going to go around the table here. Okay, these things have been done. Now we're going to set this next round.
Right.
What is your intention?
I'm going to go this way where they're going to be running with the deer.
Okay, what are your intentions?
So. Are we at the equipment wagon at this point?
No.
We haven't ran there yet?
So what's your half-elf's intention?
My half-elf's intention is to book it to that equipment.
Okay, and what about your cavalier?
And my cavalier is backing up the barbarian. I'm not backing you up. You already knocked him out. You don't need help anymore.
Okay,
I'm backing him up to see...
Running for the equipment wagon.
Okay.
As fast as I can go.
Comes after the barbarian.
And what's your cleric's intention?
He's watching his big black ball, make sure there ain't nobody coming through. Because if there is, he's going to back it up and keep him blinded.
Okay, what's the barbarian's intention?
Barbarian's intention is grabbing the girl and heading for the whoop. Well, he's going to tell the girl to go with him.
All right.
Wait, so he's...
And he's backing up the clerk, make sure he don't get fucked.
Okay.
So, your barbarian's taking the girl or your barbarian's taking the girl?
Well, I told the girl to go with him.
Okay, so you have to carry equipment and the girl?
No, she's awake.
She's awake. She could
she's healed.
Well, didn't you say she had to carry her anyways?
If needed, he can grab her and carry her.
Okay. That's why.
If she takes an arrow in the back, I can carry her, but until then, she's running.
If she takes an arrow in the back, she's probably.
She's probably still healthier than him.
Yeah. You'd be dead.
He's seen a bison, he's done for.
Gotta watch out for the
stray squirrel.
The rad
bird trips you. Yeah.
See, because they can try to get the gale.
Okay, so now let's roll your initiatives.
Yeah, I thought we already did. I told
you. No, it was just two casters.
No.
The casters were rolling.
Six.
Nine.
Okay. I got five.
Two.
You caught me.
You're not going to get running very
good. Six.
Seven.
Okay.
What?
Why is that part of reaction adjustment?
Yes.
Four.
Well, who's running?
Are we going low or high?
I don't know. That's why I asked you earlier. Was it high or low you went for?
And he never answered.
Yeah. Since the book shows a negative, we'll make it a low.
Okay, so your reaction adjustment or your dexterity is added into this?
Zero.
Or zero.
Okay.
Okay. So it's almost immediate. Good.
Six.
Oh, no. You have zero reaction adjustment?
Yeah.
Okay, so you don't get any bonuses, so whatever you roll, you
can. Oh, I have plus two reaction adjustment.
There you go.
Okay.
Four.
Okay.
Five.
Oh, wait a minute. It is a positive.
Yeah.
So oh, it is. Yeah, they need to go high then. All right, so, sorry.
Oh, yeah.
12.
So that's good.
So it looks your reaction just on your
yeah.
dexterity, nothing. What about your cavalier?
My cavalier's, oh yeah, he's taking off his knee. It's plus two.
Okay, so you have to roll for each one of them.
Okay, so I got five on my
druid
and 10 on my cavalier.
That's good.
All right, so.
You got four. You got backup.
All right, who's got the highest?
12.
Barbarian. Okay, you're running.
I'm running.
He's running.
Church equipment. Okay. Zebo's going with you. Actually, he's ahead of you.
So, do we just assume that Zebo's going to make it?
Yeah, both him and Zebo are running. Zebo's ahead of him. Okay. And this is all kind of close at the same time. Who's next highest?
Next highest is my cavalier.
Okay.
You got 10.
Your cavalier was backing up that barbarian.
His barbarian. Is Barbarian. Yeah.
So he's running towards the equipment as well.
Okay, yeah. So both my characters running towards the equipment?
Yeah. What's the half elf's initiative?
Five.
So she's a little slow.
Alright.
She's on her way, but she's
who's
I had a 10, backing up Claire. And who had a 10?
Right, and Claire's watching the
he's watching the ball, make sure they're blinded.
Okay.
He sees anybody moving, he's gonna move the ball. Along with him and the barbarian.
Okay. The female tall elf
told. I motion
gets out.
Make sure to go with her, him.
Oh.
But she can do whatever she wants. I was like, you need to go with him, but.
She's supposed to be following.
Okay.
Her.
Or whatever she wants to do, I guess.
It's up to her.
Okay.
And then. Brandon's.
He's a complicated plan, I know.
He's not running to us, but he's running into the direction we're going to be going after we get the equipment.
Okay.
Not
the place
we're going
to
have to try. Alright,
give it a shot. What the hell? Okay. You're going to get eaten or die.
Alright.
That
was our role, yeah.
Who's this?
That's me. Clark. Barbarian, mine. Back him up.
That's my cavalier. He's backing up.
Well, they were going to run to that backside.
They're running backside, yeah. They're running around the front. They're easier to right there.
How do they get to the weapons?
My druid is on her way. She was running towards the weapons.
I guess you pull weapons out through the barn and supply spears and shit.
The second I take that crowbar and that's break the lock off.
That's going to take more precision, though, trying to get
through
those bars.
I am getting too many people there. I don't know.
Who's that?
That's me.
That's who?
This is me.
That's my druid. She's slowly getting to the equipment. So is our damsel in distress not following us? Or?
You got too many people again. Yeah. Help you. He cast on him. He cast this. He's backing him up.
Okay.
Everybody else was headed...
That way.
Somewhere.
The fuck out of there. That's where they're headed.
And you don't have your... Well, half you lean guy, but
yeah, you're up there.
He's
Yeah,
he's disguised as a dwarf.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So.
Oh, it's ready.
Well, I sleep.
Yeah,
you cast two of them.
They're down. Because it's a ring, it has an AoE.
They all get around him. Okay.
So is this our, that's our main guy,
right? Weapons drawn. Right. And they're mainly looking at that big dark hole. Okay? It's big black.
Okay, so they're kind of facing him.
But they can see.
Well, yeah. Okay.
And they shout. Point at you.
Well, we're spread out, so.
Yeah. And there's kind of like a questioning, helpless of
are they
what
just
the
like,
fuck going on, yeah. What's going is what you hear in there. So, we'll do another round now. Okay. Everybody roll initiative.
Every day.
Army.
Okay,
here it
is. 10.
You can only cast that one more time after. Or it's an AoE, so you can cast it after this one.
It has an AoE, though.
Okay, so if you hit them, they're all possible.
8.
Okay.
10.
Good.
12.
12.
Druid 5. Cavalier 8.
Barbarian 3. Cleric 6.
12.
I'm going to drop those guys. Let's sleep as well.
Okay. That's easy. Use your second mana point.
Yep, and run my count.
All right. You're able to drop
one of them. I think we don't know, but
we'll find out.
Well, it said it had area of effect.
Okay. How many... Where's your book at? Yeah. Zebo's already there. He's got his crowbar in that locking device. And give me a hand! He's got his feet up on the wagon. You know what I mean? He's actually hanging from the wagon by the bar, feet against the wagon. His weight's not enough.
Grab the bar and use my exceptional strength.
Alright. What's your
Pin bars and lift gates, I suppose.
Yeah, plus you got a crowbar.
Well, it's 30% plus whatever the crowbar does.
20% added.
50 or below, you got it.
Black side. 14! Snap!
Oh, yeah, just busts right off the wood. Door swing is open.
Oh, yeah. Now we're getting somewhere.
And you guys are, and you're able to run right up and start grabbing.
Grab whatever fire.
Okay. Next.
6.
Okay.
Well, since he said he got him, ball moving.
So these guys are out?
He don't know if he got it.
He doesn't know.
Well, he cast it, I'm assuming.
Okay.
I'm going to move the ball. If I see anybody that's on their feet, it's going to go back to where it was. If not, it's going to go right over here.
Okay. Now, before
if
that...
I'm
just going to have to roll...
Whatever, just so they can't see.
Just going to have to roll random.
Yep, do it.
Okay. Except for him. 8 doesn't count.
Are you blessed out of it? Are you blessed out of it?
Who's that?
That is.
That is
Suvius.
Suvius Thane, the cleric.
His armor class.
Yeah, armor class 4.
I'm used to just blowing it sideways, so I blow it in.
Blow it that way.
Well, I'm not trying to. I've been trying to blow it right back there and over there.
Yeah.
I haven't blown it in.
I haven't noticed. I'm probably doing official now since I brought it to me.
12 points.
Wow.
That was a very large arrow.
Do you think?
So, who's...
They fired a horse, though.
He falls. His spell's gone.
And that lifts him up into the air and backwards. Boom.
So, is that your barbarian?
This is cleric.
No, I meant like behind him. There's probably
no, that's you. Oh yeah, this is my barbarian.
Yeah, I was gonna say he's probably just big enough and all that, but like how far down is he?
-2.
-2. So
he's unconscious. And bleeding.
Next round, all of these people are getting stuff out.
Again.
Getting all your gear out. I mean, just, you know,
it's like, here, catch!
Zeebo's in there, Zeebo's in there tossing stuff, you guys are grabbing stuff and pulling it out.
Well, his action?
Yeah.
Once he falls, grab him. Over the shoulder, and his full sprint.
Okay, what are you doing?
I'm already gone.
Because he didn't get an action yet this round.
I'm already gone.
Okay. You're getting closer to the trees right now.
I am.
Okay. All right, so now we'll go into the next round. You guys are getting your stuff, okay? Everybody heading?
Mm-hmm.
And of course, there'll be looks behind you, you know. And you see them, they're still, they're coming up, but they're not running or anything. She does something.
It's gonna be really cool.
Pops up and kills all four of them at once.
You can see her.
You can what?
Because you got him right here. Group's going this way, and you're coming right. And you see her stop as they keep going. She's got that thing that was around her neck. She looks to make sure everybody's behind her, and she throws it. Right. And that little necklace with the blue gem-looking kind of thing. And it lands right in front of them, you know. And
she did that earlier.
You know, they stop for a second, and I keep going, no more than one step. You heard of this? You think it resembles something you've read about? But not this way, just the magnitude of it. Boom! And it is an explosion so large that within a 20-foot radius, the grass is immediately. And you think you saw body parts flying? Horses bolt. They tear up their, however they were tethered, a lot of them have bolted. The draft and the riding. You're not near any civilization. Otherwise people would have heard it many, many, many miles away. Boom! Two barbarian, well, one of them's out.
Right? No, Clarence out.
Okay. You're able to run faster. You want no part of that. Actually, your guy didn't see.
No.
Yours did. that set off a what the fuck alarm.
Yeah.
But you heard it and you saw kind of a shockwave come off of it real quick. Because you were already ahead of the group watching them. You actually saw her toss as well. She figured it must have been some sort of potion or some sort of magic device she threw. But you're running like bats out of hell towards the woods. And you guys hit the woods, and it's no more than another 50 yards, and it becomes real woods. Okay? Along with the ground already starting to rise up a little bit, because you're going to have hills coming up. And the adrenaline started to run off a little bit.
Well, I know I have to stop. Yeah. Take him and stop him. Because I know he's bleeding now. I got to stop bleeding.
And the female has been running kind of alongside you. Okay. As she can see it as well. And for some of you, you guys are kind of trying to stick together. This strange elf woman, she's kind of waving and she's chattering for everybody to come over. And of course, not really too many of you saw what happened, but you saw him carrying that cleric. And so the arrow's not in the cleric, the arrow went through. Yeah. But still alive, right? Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's like new in his first aid, which will give him a hit point back and stop all bleeding.
Okay. Is there anything else? Can anybody else? Can you do any healing?
No.
Okay.
I can't do anything worthwhile right now.
You don't have access to those yet. Very good. All right, so you're able to do that.
Yeah, because, you know, Tegan's like, the dude came up with the plan. He figured this out and he got us out of there. I'm going to take care of him. I don't care if he casts magic or not. This wasn't a bad magic for him. This was a good magic for him. You know what I mean?
At next level, we can freely associate with clerics.
So, it doesn't matter. He's taking care of this guy because he got him out of getting at a bad situation. So that's what he's doing. Because barbarians do not like magic. Period.
No.
So that's the only reason why he's taking care of this guy. Just making that clear for everybody. He got us out of a bad situation. He's the one who came up with the plan, and he's the one who got us out of there.
Now, I'm going to have to, unless you tell me otherwise, I'm going to have to assume that you, once that's done, you pick him back up and proceed. Can you, yes, Mom?
Can you take this lid off this woman?
Yeah. I assume that you proceed and keep proceeding with that.
Yeah, we're going to divvy up weapons as we're going.
We should go back to the wagons and check the other bodies for the guys that are dead.
For more? Yeah, but we don't know how many of those guys are still left alive, and there's no way we're going
to these guys are dead, and they're not awake for us now.
They're not dead. They're asleep.
A 30-foot radius, you're dead. At least one. The explosion.
The explosion probably killed those ones.
Yeah, okay, I got you. Makes sense.
But I mean, like, 5, 10, 15...
That guy that's in the front is totally fucking dead. There's no way he's alive. Because that landed right in front of him.
But I mean, if they had more of those necklaces, that'd be your best way to
communicate with them. Right, so... Or they're in those backpacks in that other part. That's where their backpacks are.
That's true.
Right? Or there's some backpacks in there.
Yeah, their backpacks
are right there. Hey,
Randy. Yeah?
Were the silver backpacks in...
Yeah.
The same cart or the cart our equipment was in?
They were in the same cart.
All the equipment was in the same cart.
Oh, okay, so we don't have to worry about it.
We might have or we might not.
Yeah, they could be in there if there's
anything. We were, you know, there wasn't time to like discern. It was just grab the stuff.
And I'm just like, oh, here, I think this one's in the woods. You take this one.
Let's go. 30% chance. Didn't grab any.
Didn't grab any silver ones? But is there any more of those necklaces?
No.
We didn't grab any silver backpacks.
There's a brisk out there.
Yeah, it is.
I should buy you again, brother.
Good thing my thighs aren't really huge. I'm not there.
All right. I suggest if we're running. I'm sorry. I'm jumping back into the conversation. You guys are talking about going back. I'm healing.
Well, we decided not to because we already rolled for the chance of. Well, right. Did we? Oh no, we didn't grab any silver backpacks.
Yeah, I was just checking to see if we might have.
We had like a 30% chance of grabbing the silver backpacks, hoping maybe one of those necklaces was in the loop.
Now, if you guys would have told me immediately, I would have went with it. But.
Oh, well, I'll be alright.
So.
There's seven of us, so. Well, eight now. So you got that message?
About 2 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, yeah.
About right. 2 o'clock in the morning.
I was wanting to count to halfway twice, apparently.
Two, four, five, six, seven, eight. Yeah, there's 8 of us.
About 2 o'clock in the morning, if you go any farther west, you climb up out of the. The trees will give way to just rough, rocky hill like terrain.
So it's the next day?
It's about 2 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, okay. So
about time for everybody to rest.
I was going to say, as we're moving, we need to start divvying up weapons, so people got weapons at least.
You guys are able to do that. Like I said, about 2 o'clock, you figure it's time for a rest. There's none of you have eaten in the day, and a third. So it's time to replenish and to rest.
Food.
So we were able to. How much of our stuff were we able to get back? You're able to get back your gear. Lance, no. Weapons, yes. Standard gear, yeah. Pretty much.
Yeah,
we
didn't do much good.
Barbarians can hunt and like set traps and stuff.
Well, I was getting ready to say if we need, we could go scramble for berries and shit. We have food. Because I had 4 weeks iron rats. Both my guys.
I think
as long as you have backpacks, everybody's eating.
And we did get the backpacks right.
And
yeah,
I think we're right. I can give you one more hit point back on the cleric because that female elf is good ministry.
Either way, he can groggy at 0.
Okay.
Tomorrow would be at 2, and then he can help himself.
So, the female, the tall female elf, especially to you, tries to explain something brief, and then just shakes her head.
Yeah, because we can understand.
Now, in and out of consciousness, I'll let him know, because if the cleric, mm-hmm. he can go, look, that necklace let her talk to us. And she told me as soon as she took it off, she's not gonna be able. We're not gonna be able to understand her. So she sacrificed a lot.
and she lays down to get some rest too.
And you set a watch.
Yep.
I still have a -1 wound.
From the handcuffs.
From the cuff.
Yeah.
Not handcuffs.
Cuff.
Sorry. I got hit.
Yeah, that's
why. Yeah, we're making handcuffs. That would have been funnier than
that. Yeah,
okay. That's what I didn't realize.
You guys, you get a hit point back after an hour.
Real quick, out again, 8 hours.
Yeah.
Out again, hit points work. Okay, so you take damage. When you hit 0, you're unconscious, groggy, unconscious. When you hit -10, you are dead. Okay. Now, hit points are regained at 1 point per day plus Constitution. And if somebody is healing you, like there's a skill called healing, barbarians have it. If we are taking care of you during that, you get an extra one. So you get your normal 1 per day, plus your constitution, plus 1 for us taking care of you. That's why I wanted to set him down and start working on him, because I have the natural ability. I don't even have to take it as a skill class. I have it. I can set bones, sprains, I can stop bleeding, I can take care of wounds. So can his barbarian. So recovering hit points is a good thing. Now, since the cleric's the only guy who can cure anybody right now, and he's the one that got knocked out, we need to make sure he's okay. Because he's going to have to cure himself, and it's going to take a full day for him to do it. Because he's going to have to use all 3 of his spells to get back to his hit points, most likely. Unless I roll really well. So tomorrow morning, 8 hours of sleep. That's when you get your hit point plus your constitution. Okay? That's how you recover those.
And your mana.
And your mana. For spellcasters besides clerics. The arcane spellcasters. Which worked out well.
You're pretty good.
So, now, it's going to be about time to wrap up. Because I know you got to go to bed. And this is actually, it's a good stopping point. But, as a little teaser, you guys are to make a really rough camp for the evening. Not much. It's really just everybody hunkering down. Zeebel tells you a little bit more about what he understood that these Agar were up to. From the sounds of it, he says, they were on that noble-looking Agar was trying to find a cave that he'd been to before where he had gotten his sword because he figured there were more there. But they were having trouble finding it, couldn't know what was at. His guards was his personal buddies and retinue. Okay. And they weren't supposed to be away from the horde either.
Oh,
that's
right.
That little extra popo there.
And that's why they knew they were tickled. They were being naughty boys, and they were going to go ahead and feast anyway, because nobody was going to know. Because he's away from his uncle. He knows that too. That noble, that young noble Agar, he's away from his uncle. His uncle is the Karkor. So that he was hoping to go on this little expedition of his own. Gosh. Without permission.
Been nice driving that sword, yes.
You have to fucking
run. I'm thinking we should be looking for the cave. Dwarven weapons would be nice to have.
Yeah, okay.
Not a bad idea.
We just have to retrace our steps and follow the ones that are still alive.
Problem is, you got 1, 2, 3, 4 dead Agar. That's 4,000 people.
If they find out that they're dead. So we'd have to go back.
They disappeared. Now.
Yeah, good point. So they're just going to assume
that. And they blew up. Yeah. Now there's 3 left who split off and went with them, so are they going to lie now? Well, he went to the cave and they disappeared and that's it. Or are they going to tell them that some humans kicked their ass?
Yeah, like little bitches.
So we may be okay.
Yeah.
I hope.
Because they're going to admit humans kicked their ass. Yeah. Because that's kind of what we did.
Those three only have one action, really one chance to save their ass.
Go ahead, I'm sorry.
Those three only, conceivably, the way I think of it, is they only have one way to save their ass.
Because?
Get us?
Yeah.
Yeah, because...
So they're going to come after us.
They probably get some sort of repercussion for feeding.
Regardless, they just killed their leader's nephew.
We didn't necessarily kick their asses, but we kind of outsmarted them.
He's back.
He died. He was back here.
Quick.
Did he die?
Yeah.
Without her, we don't get away. And without that blast, we don't get away. But these three, I mean, we did the best we could with what we had. If I wouldn't have got hit with that arrow, I still had these guys.
You know, an Agar can shoot a bow at 150 yards.
So, are we assuming that these two are dead
one,
since they were so close D12. To the explosion?
Okay.
That one's not dead.
He's gonna wake up and have no idea what the hell went on anyway.
Yeah. He's gonna be like, oh shit. Okay. So, did any of those die? Probably more than likely the guy that was in the very front.
Well, we saw body parts flying. At least that's what he said. So, yeah, I'm assuming they're
dead.
These guys, maybe one got
maybe
hurt.
One lost an arm or something.
Yeah, it depends on how long that blast radius was. I don't think it was 40 feet. Maybe 20.
He said 30.
Zeebo remembers one other thing, too.
Yeah?
If there's a cave around here, he remembers, because he's done some traveling. that... Here, let me get the big man. Here's what I remember.
So where were we? Were we like way down there?
We were up over here, I thought.
No.
What didn't you say? We were following the river, going northwest?
No, this river. No, that river there. These are the woods. These are the hills.
Okay, I got you.
You guys are way over here.
Yeah. Okay. Oh,
first
yeah,
you went this way, then you turn around and start going this way.
Oh, okay.
You guys are about right in this area. All right.
So we cross the river.
About right in here. I could zoom in, but I can't on this. This is a still photo.
What is that little formation there?
This thing right here? This is, see this thing here?
Yeah.
This is what Zeebo remembers. He remembers that there's this ancient bridge here. It's not a very, like I said, it's about the size of the Potoka River. But this ancient stone bridge has all kinds of ancient carvings on it that he figured are dwarven. And the only there's no road or nothing. The bridge actually is, well, what he remembers is pretty, the rock and everything about the bridge is pretty worn smooth because it's actually, for herd animals, it's a great way to cross that little river, you know. So, you know, buffalo might go across it, you know. All kinds of things. But you figure there's probably, if there were a cave, it's going to be up in this area right here.